primary ideology or primary ideas that fuel Gorgoroth's music.
Nature being ruined by man, global warming. Do you think nature has the ability to stand up against man?
Of course.
Yeah. How?
Man is a small piece of nature.
How do you think it will happen then? What?
I'm certain it will happen, but I don't know how it will happen, and. It's not for me to know.
A lot of some of the people who liked your previous music might follow you into newer paths.
Mm.
Is there also maybe a new crowd of people or group of people that catches your interest now because of the message behind the music that they are more involved with it?
I think it's in a way more safe than black metal is.
Mm-hmm.
So, but it probably can be to interest for anyone from the smallest child to the oldest man or woman.
Afterbirth, but not reincarnation in that form. I don't believe that one can be a slug and then become man, or opposite. I don't believe in that connection. I believe in species for species.
It's not every time you go on stage performing metal that you manage to be it completely, even though you should get close to it.
But maybe if your metal performance wasn't that bounded to more industry-like performance because you have to perform more maybe in crowd. If maybe metal was more scarce and you maybe had to perform only one show a year, would it be different then for you? Would you still?
One of the reasons why we don't rehearse or over-rehearse too much is to try to maintain the
freshness.
Yeah, it is. I think that's important too. Because if you, and also this comes back to the combination Vanir answer, when things are too constructed and into too much of a form, then it loses its childishness in a way. It loses its honesty. Well, it doesn't need to, but it can easily be turned into
something bigger than it is.
Yeah, it can easily turn into an act instead of actually honesty.
Is that something that you've learned now over the years
to maintain this? I think I've always had that in mind. So it's I have to forget how to paint before I paint a new picture. So it doesn't get into a technique or into
routine.
Of course, there's a technique there,
mm-hmm.
but you should be what you do, and therefore you have to become the child in every.
If you look at your life now until now, creatively, is there maybe a pattern that you can recognize or that you maybe practice some period an art form and then switch later on to a fresh one? Or maybe you revisit each art form each several years?
I revisit things always, everything. I do things when it feels right. And people might think that one only do what they see out in the world or... But I'm working on many different things, on even though it's just, if it's just for me and my closest friends. So I do a lot of things that's not out in and have been doing. So,
but do you think that art maybe nowadays, as it's presented, is more bound to ego than it maybe used to be? Because people now have all the chance to maybe bring out everything, and then maybe...
Yeah, it can easily... one can easily want to expose oneself too much. So, it's... Luckily, I'm shy, so I manage to keep things to myself. Even though that might be the best things I do. It's
embody, or what does he represent?
Freedom.
I think whether we like it or not, black metal in Norway is known for a string of events that happened in the early 1990s around a series of arsons. I'm interested to know your thoughts on the actions of those events, the motivations behind those events, whether you agree with them, whether you disagree.
Church burnings and all these things are, of course, a thing that I support 100%, and it should have been done much more and will be done much more in the future. We have to remove every trace from what Christianity and the Semitic roots have to offer this world.
Never thought I'd get to meet the devil. Never thought I'd meet him face to face. Heard he always worked the dome, that he seldom rode or used a phone. So I walked right up to meet him at his place.
You are no good low-life motherfucker, piece of shit!
Fuck you, punk! I'll fuck you! I'll fuck your sister, but not your wife! Because I respect your wife!
Another cocksucker, male prostitute! Soon or late, I'm gonna get even with you, fuck cocksucker motherfucker!
Wow.
Not to suplex him, put him in the camel clutch, and I fuck his ass! With 10 inch my cock.
But then
I'm gonna fuck your mother, I'm gonna fuck your sister, and I'm gonna tell my agents he locked the gay fag like you. I tell my agents, Eric Sims, fuck your ass.
I'm fucking embarrassing. Ah, pal, fuck you.
Go fuck yourself. You can't even suck my 10 inch cock. I fuck your Jesus, I fuck your God, and I'm gonna fuck your sister because you are no good low-life motherfucker.